present here. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to the lecture demonstration by Nancy Kulkarni ji. Kulkarni ji plays cello, and this event is organized by Ahmedabad University Music Club, Going Gaga, in collaboration with SPICMACAY, Society for Promotion of Indian Classical Music and Culture Amongst Youth. Is a voluntarily apolitical participatory student movement which aims to enrich the education process by exposing students to the rich cultural traditions of India. SPICMACAY has more than 300 chapters both in India and abroad. It organizes more than 2,500 programs every year in schools and colleges. We are so fortunate and particularly happy today that SPICMACAY has come to Ahmedabad University. Nancy Lesh Kulkarni ji is a classically trained cellist who has devoted herself to the study and performance of Dhrupad music of India on the cello for the last 30 years. Before pursuing Dhrupad, she was the co-principal cellist on the Rome Festival Orchestra and section cellist with the Chicago Civic Orchestra and Orchestra del Maggio, Musicale of Florence, Italy. Since 1982, Nancy G has been playing on Dhrupad on her cello. She is deeply grateful for the training she received from senior Dhrupad vocalist Pandit Ritvik Sanyal ji in Varanasi and from renowned Veena and vocal brothers Zia Muhyiddin Dagar ji and Ustad Zia Farid Uddin Dagar ji in Mumbai. She has also received valuable guidance from her guru bhais Ustad Bahuddin Dagar ji, Pandit Pushpraj Koshdi ji, Pandit Uday Babalkar ji and Pandit Nirmalay Deji. Nancy has given hundreds of Dhrupad recitals and lecture demonstrations in US universities and concert halls and in major cities across the nation. She has twice been awarded the Senior Performing Art Fellowship by the American Institute of Indian Studies and was featured in the film Before My Eyes by Manikol and Veer by Umesh Kulkarni ji. Nancy's playing has been presented several times on National Public Radio, All India Radio and TV, and she has released 3 solo CDs. Nancy ji resides in Pune, India, where she continues her Dhrupad study, performance and teaching. She teaches Dhrupad cello to students to all ages and levels in Pune and on Skype. We are highly grateful to you, ma'am, for coming here in this session. I now request Ahmedabad University Music Club coordinator student to accord floral welcome to Nancy ji. From Ahmedabad University Music Club to offer floral welcome to Dhaval Mistry ji on the Pakavaj. I would also request the student volunteer to honor Mr. Onur Dagli ji on Tanpuran Malu. So without making much ado, let's just have all the ears for the lecture demonstration by Nancy G.
Thank you so much. We're so happy to be here today and to see all your smiling faces. It's really a joy to be here and thank you so much for coming. We've been looking especially forward to this program. So now, this is actually the last program in our tour. SPICMACAY has been giving us a tour of so many schools and universities. So tomorrow we go back to actually Lonavala, which is near to Pune where we stay. So happy to finish our tour with this beautiful program tonight. We're going to present to you Raga Abhogi. So without further ado, we'll begin. I'm going to first present Alap Joran Chala.
Thank you. Thank you.
Sections of the alap. First is alap proper, where we play slow, meditative, peaceful. Second section in the alap is called jor, and that one we have a regular pulse, which I'm indicating with the use of the chikari. That extra string I added to the cello, that's not traditionally used on the cello, and I got the inspiration from that from my ustad Ziamohyudin Dagar, who was a great beamcutter. So he only gave me the idea for the chikari on the cello. So that one I use in jor and in jala. So the jala is the fast section that you just heard. So now you've heard alap jor jala. We're going to continue with the fourth section in the Dhrupad style, which is going to be the composition. And in this case, we're going to perform for you sultal and madhya laya in rag abhauki. This is with pakalaj, which is the traditional instrument that's always used for Dhrupad music. So tabal is first we'll do a little demonstration on pakalaj so you can understand what this instrument is. This instrument has its origins in the temples of India. It's a traditional temple instrument, and for many hundreds of years it was only played in the temple. Very ancient instrument, pakalaj. In fact, it's the most ancient instrument in all of India. So now the left-hand drum, side of the drum, the bainhat, has a raw chapati dough, which he's applying to that head every time before playing. And he's removing it after the program. That gives that moist dough, is giving that booming, rich sound that you hear in the left hand of the pakalaj. The right hand of the drum is similar to tabla. It has the black spot that you see here, which is called shahi. So that's giving a clear, ringing sound, similar to what you hear in tabla. And he's using a mixture of bowls. The beautiful thing about the pakalaj is that the two heads are in within one drum, unlike the tabla, which is split. This one is a single drum, so the two heads are literally talking to each other. And the sympathetic vibrations from one stroke from the right side to the left side are amazing. And he's tuning the drum using that atta. By putting more or less, he's able to actually tune the left-hand head. And in this case, he has tuned it to a perfect madhyam. So that madhyam and the left and the sharanj and the right are creating a perfect consonance, samvad. So that is creating a very beautiful sound in the pakalaj, which is unique to this instrument. And my favorite drum in all of India, without doubt, is this pakalaj. It has such a beautiful, rich, deep sound. And it's in perfect harmony with the deep tones of the cello. So now, please enjoy Sultan in Rag Abhauki. after this composition, we'll be taking a number of questions from the audience. So while you're listening to the music, if you have anything you want to ask about my instrument, about my journey from the United States to India, and how I got interested in this music, all those personal details, I'm happy to share with you. If you want to ask about Pakawaj drum, Tanampura, any question you may have, feel free to ask after this sultan.
Thank you.
Career in teaching and playing common Turkish music so that he can now devote the rest of his life to playing and learning Dhrupad on kanun. And actually, this kanun is a traditional instrument for Dhrupad. It was, and it was forgotten for about 30 years. So he is reviving that instrument as a Dhrupad instrument. So we'll be sharing that with you after this question-answer session. Yes?
Since you come from a Western classical tradition as well, so I wanted to know something about the drone shift which you have in Western classical.
The which shift?
Drone shift. Since the drone strings on the tanpura, they are constant, whereas in a Western classical composition, we can shift.
Right. Yeah. Actually, we don't even have drone in Western music. This concept of drone that continues through the whole piece, we don't use that in Western music. In our music, either it's in one key, if you're talking about older music like Mozart, Haydn, Bach, generally those compositions will stay in one key. Means fixed sa, just like I'm playing on cello. From beginning to end, sa will be, let's say, in C. And that will continue. But mostly in the Western tradition, that sa is always shifting. So for 2 minutes, you'll hear sa on C. Then you hear it on G. Then you might hear it on F. Always that tonality, what we call tonality, is shifting. And we call that tonal shift, or you can also call it transposition. So we do that in Western music very commonly. Here in India, no. Fix sa from beginning to end. That's the om. And we keep that as a constant.
And the other thing about the half tones that they play, whereas in these, we can go up to the micro, explore the shruti.
And no limit. No. It's not only shruti, it's micro shruti. You know, you notice when I'm playing this ga, for instance, I just demonstrate micro shruti.
I can make mead. I can do any amount of mead on cello. I'm completely
reed. So this instrument is perfect instrument for Dhrupad. And in fact, when I came to India first time in 1982, I was 22 years old that time, and I played Bach suite in the BHU, Banaras Hindu University. And the Dean of Music heard me playing that Bach suite. She came to me afterwards and said, "This instrument, perfect for Dhrupad." I said, "What is Dhrupad? I don't know anything about Dhrupad. I never even heard this word Dhrupad before." She said, "Don't worry. We have one professor at BHU. His name is Dr. Ritwik Sanyal. He's expert in Dhrupad. You go to him." Next morning, I go to Sanyal Guruji. From that day on, no more Western music. I'm only learning Dhrupad because he sang for me Bhairo Alap in Dhrupad. And I'm playing that on my cello. I'm following that. I'm like, wow, how my instrument is sounding so different. It's not even sounding like Western instruments. It's sounding like some amazing thing. So when I got that sound in my mind, that Dhrupad sound, I knew this is it. No going back now. Forget about Western music. This is my karma is now with Dhrupad. So this instrument is very much perfect for Dhrupad, and there's no problem with it. I don't have to make any alteration, nothing. It's even without chikai, you can play Dhrupad on this instrument. Yeah. And you also heard I'm playing gamak. Not just me, I'm playing gamak very easily on this instrument. So many of those Dhrupad techniques, like mean, gamak, sunt, all of these things are naturally played on my instrument. Yes.
Hello, ma'am. We all have heard Indian classical music on the violin. So I wanted to ask, is cello more difficult to play than violin?
Both are same. Actually, any instrument is same. You can't say one is more difficult, one is the other, because at the highest level, all instruments have an amazing capacity for refinement and for making that sound happen. Piano, all those things. So I'll never say that one instrument is more difficult than any other instrument. Violin and cello, both are easy. Both are very enjoyable. All of you people can learn. No problem. Okay? Yeah, but it is similar to violin, correct? Yes?
I can love. For the Kakavish player especially, how do you... So this group was in five, right? The previous one you played was in five.
Actually 10.
10, yeah, 10, sorry. So how do you keep the groove once he was soloing on it? So that's one thing I wanted to ask, and followed by, is it possible to make it polyrhythmic? Because one can go in four and you can go in five and then meet after 20 or something like that. That's the
yes.
question.
The answer is yes. Go ahead.
Are you haan, main bolta hai na. अच्छा आप जो अभी 10 के ताल जो 10 मात्रा का था उसमें आप जो पल्स रहता है वो कैसे रखते हो जब आप सोलो पे जाते हो खुद का जो इम्प्रोवाइजेशन जैसा होता है
अच्छा उस पर तो मेरे लिए तो ये बजाते हैं ना
हाँ पर वही पूछ रहा हूँ अगर वो पॉसिबिलिटी है कि ये अलग सिग्नेचर में चले जाए मतलब 4 पे चले जाए और आपको 20 मात्रा के बाद मिले या तो 25
हाँ हो सकता है ऐसे टाइम पे लेकिन खुद को पहले इतना ताल पक्का होना चाहिए खुद के अंदर इतना चलना चाहिए कि वो अगर 10 से 10:30 पे जा रही है तो मुझे उस हिसाब से बजाना पड़ेगा
अच्छा
वो हमारे दिमाग में पहले से ऐसे फिट करके रखते हैं एक मात्रा आपने कहा कि 10 मात्रा का ताल लेकिन मेरे अंदर चल रही है 40 मात्रा मेरे दिमाग में एक मात्रा के 4 पीसेस हम करके चलते हैं तो वो अगर आधी से भी कम में अगर वो हिलेगी या पहली पे बढ़ गई या कम हो गई तो हम तुरंत उसको एडजस्ट कर पाते हैं
मतलब आप ताकि धीमे ताकि धीमे ताकि धीमे ताकि
कुछ भी कुछ भी
एक मतलब मैं कोनो कोल में बता रहा हूँ मतलब ऐसे
ऐसे
बिल्कुल थैंक यू ओके नाउ वी आल्सो वांट टू लीव प्लेंटी ऑफ टाइम सो वी आर गोइंग टू नाउ हैव अ शॉर्ट आलाप ऑन कानून फॉलोड बाय चोताल नो सॉरी तमार with all three of us playing together. I'll also want to get... But they all even file. Okay, fine. I'm so small. Are you sure?
Thank you.
Music, don't you?
A little bit.
Yeah, great.
Actually, these motifs that you're talking about, when he says motif, what we mean is musical motif, M-O-T-I-F, motif. Motif means a short phrase like a catchphrase. So what happens in this rag is I'll start to play and I hear something that I did. It strikes me as beautiful. Ah, let's do that again, right? Let's make some variation on that thing. So spontaneously I'm creating those motifs. So what you just heard me play, for example, I'll just show you one motif.
Instruments of India, like Rudra Veena. So many are there. Surbahar.
So I decided, without a doubt, I cannot learn any other instrument. This is my instrument. This is like my own voice. I'm so identified, my atma sat, okay? I'm completely connected with this instrument and this sound of the cello. I want to hear it every day of my life. I love that deep, low, ringing sound that's very sustained. To me, that's like heaven. So I said, okay, fine. I don't know whether this is going to work or not, success, failure, I don't know, but I must play cello only. And if I'm learning Dhrupad, fine, then I'm learning on cello. So that's how the cello came to me, music. And I can say now that I'm the first artist ever to be a graded artist on All India Radio on this instrument. And because of my acceptance on All India Radio and TV, now the cello is open as a regular instrument for performing Indian classical music. So this instrument now has got the approval of the All India Radio and TV as a regular classical music solo instrument. So anyone that comes after me playing the cello will get easily access to all of these things. So like violin now, I can say that I really did bring the cello to India as a solo classical instrument. So that I feel very happy about that. It's helping other people. Yes?
No question, but one quick comment. I'm sure everybody here would agree with me. I would like to actually applaud you and thank you and him and other people who have come from abroad, understood, accepted, and adopted and appreciated Indian art and culture.
Yes.
It's very unfortunate that this hall is not full.
SPICMACAY likes small audiences because that personal contact is there. So
yeah,
no problem.
I wish that hall would have been full.
I'll come again and play for other students. I would be happy to play for all the students at your university. But I like the small group. This is great because I can really see all of your faces, your beautiful smiling faces, and I can understand how you are catching that music. So this is, for me, very nice. Okay, we're going to share with you now another rag. You've heard so much of a bogey tonight, you must be completely immersed in that sound. We're going to change something now and present to you, finally, a piece in rag Bhairavi, which is a very romantic rag and is traditionally done at the end of a program. So now enjoy Tivratal in rag Bhairavi.
Thank you.
Fourth time she's inviting me, and I just love to come to Gujarat. last time I played in the blind school and in the orphanages, and for so many children, it was so fantastic. This time also, playing for all of you, thanking Sushmaji with all my heart.
Thank you, Ahmedabad University as well, and the volunteers of Ahmedabad University. I hope you all have a good evening. I'm sure we will after this performance. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.